وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Welcome to another Ramadan Daily Droplets. As this month of Ramadan comes to a close, we find ourselves at the end of Ramadan. And what is obligatory upon us is to work hard and put our concentration towards the acceptance of our deeds being accepted. Allah Azza wa Jal, He told us in the Qur'an, in Surah Al-Muzzammil, in ayah number 20, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُم مِّن خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ هُوَ خَيْرًا وَأَعْظَمَ أَجْرًا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ Whatever you put forward for yourselves from good, you will find it with Allah. And you will find it with Allah Azza wa Jal to be better and greater in reward. And seek the forgiveness of Allah, and Allah is the all-forgiving and the most merciful. Al-Imam Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, وَفِي الْأَمْرِ بِالْإِسْتِغْفَارِ بَعْدَ الْحَثِّ عَلَىٰ أَفْعَالِ الطَّاعَةِ وَالْخَيْرِ فَائِدَةٌ كَبِيرَةٌ وَذَلِكَ أَنَّ الْعَبْدِ مَا يَخْلُو مِنَ التَّقْصِيرِ فِي مَا أُمِرَ بِهِ إِمَّا أَنْ لَا يَفْعَلَهُ أَصْلًا أَوْ يَفْعَلَهُ عَلَىٰ وَجْهِ النَّاقِصِ He said, and as for Allah commanding us to make istighfar, after encouraging us to do acts of obedience and good, this has a huge benefit. And that is that a person, they will not cease. It's not possible for them to have done this act without some deficiency in what they were commanded to do. Either they didn't do it at all, or they did it in a way that wasn't complete and wasn't, it was deficient. And subhanAllah, look at the benefit. Look at the benefit. Why Allah Azza wa Jalla told us to do good. Whatever good you do, you'll find it with Allah. Wastaghfirullah, and ask Allah to forgive you. Because every good you have done, it is naqis. There is taqsir, there is deficiency, there is naqs, it isn't done the way that it should have been done. It's not perfect. So you ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to forgive you. So he said, فَأُمِرَ بِتَرْقِيعِ ذَلِكَ بِالْإِسْتِغْفَارِ He was commanded, the servant was commanded to patch it up by making istighfar. Because the servant commits sins all throughout the day and all throughout the night. فَمَتَى لَمْ يَتَغَمَّدْهُ اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَتِهِ وَمَغْفِرَتِهِ فَإِنَّهُ هَالِكَ So if a person doesn't, Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't shower them with His mercy and His forgiveness, that person is halik, they've been destroyed. SubhanAllah, you thought after you finished the month of Ramadan and Ramadan came to the close, SubhanAllah, what did we think that we had done? Did we think that we had done something that was complete and perfect the way that Allah Azza wa Jal commanded us? If Allah doesn't shower us with His rahmah and His maghfirah, then nothing would have been accepted from us. And nothing would be accepted from us. Because it was naqis. We had taqsir. We were deficient. We fell short in what we were commanded to do. And we need the mercy of Allah and His forgiveness to make up for our shortcomings. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلرَّسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَحُولُ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَقَلْبِهِ وَأَنَّهُ إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ Allah Azza wa Jalla in Surah Al-Anfal, He said, O you who believe, answer the call of Allah and His Messenger when they call you to that which will bring you life, and know that Allah comes between a person and their heart, and that to Him you will be gathered. SubhanAllah, we have to be quick. We have to race and to rush to answer the call of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Whatever is left from the month of Ramadan, we use it to obey Allah Azza wa Jalla because the actions are judged by the end of what you do. And whatever we're not able to do, we ask Allah's forgiveness. And we race to do that before Allah Azza wa Jal seals a person's heart and comes between a person and their heart. And Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, فَإِيَّاكُمْ أَن تَرُدُّوا أَمْرَ اللَّهِ أَوَّلَ مَا يَأْتِيكُمْ. He said, be so careful, beware, that you refuse the command of Allah when it first comes to you. فَيُحَالُ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَهُ. And so Allah Azza wa Jal seals the path or blocks the path between you and between him. إِذَا أَرَدْتُمُوهُ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ. When you need Allah after that. وَتَخْتَلِفُ قُلُوبُكُمْ. And your hearts differ. Subhanallah. You need Allah after the month of Ramadan. Something happens the next month, some difficulty, some trouble, and you realize how much you need Allah. Then quickly, quickly use the time that you have. Make the benefit of the time that you have. How many people we see, subhanallah, and it makes you feel so upset that you see the 27th night and you see the masjid full to the brim. And then you see the 28th night and maybe you only see just a few people in the saf. And even the 29th night, which is an odd night, and still you see very, very few people come to the masjid. Be quick to answer the call of Allah before Allah comes between you and your heart. And then when you need Allah after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you'll find a barrier between you and Allah. And your hearts will differ. That's what Imam al-Sa'di, he said, rahimahullahu ta'ala. And Allah azza wa jal said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. This is one of the most scary ayat in the Qur'an. One of the ayat that puts fear into you, or it should put fear into you. Regarding the two sons of Adam, وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ أَبْنَيْ آدَمَ بِالْحَقِّ إِذْ قَرَّبَا قُرْبَانًا فَتُقُبِّلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمَا وَلَمْ يُتَقَبَّلْ مِنَ الْآخِرِ. Recite to them the news of the two sons of Adam in truth. When they each performed a sacrifice and it was accepted from one, but it wasn't accepted from the other. قَالَ لَأَقْتُلَنَّكَ. He said, I'm going to kill you. قَالَ إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. And his brother said to him a statement that it should make you scared. Allah only accepts from the muttaqeen. Which of us can say they're from the muttaqeen? Which of us can say, knowing that the muttaqi, the one who is a person of taqwa, is the one who does everything Allah commands them to do and abstains from everything that Allah commands them to abstain from? Which of you can say that you're from the muttaqeen? Which of us can say that we're from the muttaqeen? That we do all the things that Allah commands us to do. And yet Allah said, innama, the only people Allah accepts from is the muttaqeen. And the Salaf al-Salih, they have narrations about this, that they used to be scared about this ayah. There was a man came to Ibn Umar asking him, فَقَالَ لِبْنِهِ أَعْطِهِ دِنَارًا فَقَالَ لَهُ إِبْنُهُ تَقَبَّلَ اللَّهُ مِنْكَ يَا أَبَتَهُ. He said to his son, give him a dinar. Give him a dinar. So his son, when he gave it, his son said, may Allah accept it from you, my father. He said, لو علمت أن الله تقبل مني سجدة واحدة أو صدقة درهم واحد لم يكن غائب أحب إلي من الموت. أتدري ممن يتقبل الله؟ إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين. He said, my son, if I knew Allah accepted one sajda from me or one dirham in sadaqah from me, there is nothing more beloved to me than dying at that time. I would love nothing more than to die. Do you know who Allah accepts from? إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah only accepts from the people of taqwa. SubhanAllah, that's how they understood it. That if I could just make one sajda that Allah accepted from me, then I would wish for death. Because Allah only accepts from the muttaqeen. And it's narrated from Ali radiallahu an, that he said, كُونُوا لِقُبُولِ الْعَمَلِ أَشَدَّ اهْتِمَامًا مِنْكُمْ بِالْعَمَلِ أَلَمْ تَسْمَعُوا لِقَوْلِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. He said, be more keen for Allah to accept your deeds than you are in the deeds that you do in the first place. Meaning, it's not about the number of deeds that you do. It's not about how many deeds you do. It only matters whether Allah Azza wa Jal accepts it. He said, don't you hear that Allah said, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah only accepts from the people of at-taqwa. Allah Azza wa Jal only accepts from the people of taqwa. So we need to use this time that we have in the month of Ramadan, whatever is left of it. We need to use this time to be more keen on what we do in these few hours that remain. We need to be more keen about that and more concerned about that and more careful about that than the number of actions or what we have done so far. And we need to make all of our efforts in asking Allah Azza wa Jal to accept from us. That's what Allah Azza wa Jal made easy for us to mention, and Allah Azza wa Jal knows best. Wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.